Hey guys, this is DT Gaming. Welcome back to a new episode of Russian Fishing 4. So we're gonna do some more trolling here on Arch. I don't know exactly what the weather condition is, but we're just gonna go. Someone says that the worse the weather, the better the fishing. So we'll test that theory. We're gonna go get an extra ticket. Why ain't that showing up? Hold on a minute. Okay. All right, guys, give me a brief minute. I gotta fix this. Something's not working. There. The heads up display was showing improper information. Can't see what the weather is. I know it's raining, but okay, 2.9. So the wind's not bad. Actually, weather is pretty good for the next couple few days. Oh, hours, you'd say. Rods here. I came here middle of the night and I got four hundred some silver in an hour. I missed a trophy pike if you guys seen that video. I did upload that. I wouldn't say miss. It was like about a little over 600 grams off. But still, it kind of shocked me because the way it fought, I thought it was a salmon. Like, jeez. We can just... We'll slow down now. I think we're in direct line where we want to be. So, let's see. So, as I was saying, somebody said that the bad weather brings good fish, and good weather brings bad fish. So, we're gonna test that. I don't even know if that damages the rig or not. The ruby's gone. He missed my stream yesterday, or he or she missed my stream yesterday, and I'm starting to realize that my time for 10:15 a.m. kind of makes people not able to watch my stream. Either they're in school or something. Go for all markers. don't know if it'd be too hard on the servers or on the game, because you can hear the rain, but you don't see the rain. So I'm thinking that the rain just is just for visual, but as it's being any type of collision, like for example on the windows or on yourself or on the water, you don't see the raindrop collision. So maybe they just can't do it because it takes up too much. I think it would be too much resources on people's computers. I'm gonna actually go ahead and post this real quick on I keep playing it going on live or something. Why that one ain't getting bites? Oh, there we go. So far, all markers, but there's small fish, it's not even worth anything. But I only cut fish that don't show a green tag on it. How far should you go before you turn around? Maybe once you get out there, maybe, then turn around. I mean, I suppose it won't hurt to try. I'm getting more bites though in that darker area, but not the best fish though. Can't do anything with that, so let's throw that back. Or not throw it back, well, get rid of it. Turn around now. Might not be a very good fishing session. I mean, people claim that you can get nice fish in the bad weather, so I don't know. Now I don't think I've started to wait. We'll see what the evening hour brings. I mean, I do got 3 tickets that I'm using total. We'll see how the 3 hours go. Yeah, 600 damn size Ladoga is worth anything, is it? I pay attention to that because when does it actually start counting for good silver? Hey there, Mike C. How you doing? I guess the pike is the only one that's actually biting that's decent. As for there's undersized fish, I'm still debating to either cut this one up or that one up because it's under 1,000 gram, 1 kilogram. So it makes me wonder what they're worth, but I'm gonna definitely keep an eye on that. Holy crap! Oh, shit. Holy Christ, we got a burner here right from the start. Oh, not start, but that thing got a head start on me. Time to turn around. Yeah, I could do some bull cough after. I make sure to set the hook because I don't think I remember setting it. I can hear a cracking sound, so this is a good fish. Yeah, it sure hit hard. The strange thing about it that I should have been able to hear it, but I didn't. Well, one thing is that when you're on bull cough and you got a runner like this, you have to follow them with your boat. Unfortunately, the red boat, you had to sit and steer the boat. This one, you have to basically try to steer the boat at the same time trying to fight the fish standing up. But otherwise, when you're sitting down, when you're fighting the fish, you're not getting, I don't know. I noticed that I lose more fish when you're sitting down. I'm using a controller. I'm trying to keep the boat in line with the fish going forward. That way it minimizes from burning your reel. It's obvious he's right straight down below me. Might be a sturgeon. Yeah, actually, I put a video up a while back of how to set up a controller. It should still be there on my in the videos. Look for something called X Patter. As soon as I'm done with this finished, I'll put the link in this video here so you guys know how to set up the controller. The program only costs like what, $10, and then it's forever yours. It's very helpful with games that don't use controllers. They have a hard time using keyboard or mouse because I got bad arthritis, you can see. So my hand is kind of like gets stuck like that. It's hard to really do anything with it. Oh, hey, well, you're welcome. The people made fun of me because I use a game controller. Because I don't use keyboard and mouse for some reason. I just try to make the game more comfortable for my use. And I already talked to the administration of my situation, and they gave me permission that I can use that program to play the game. And since then, they allowed people on Steam to use the game controllers. Question though, are you on Steam or are you using standalone? Steam. Okay. Now this program don't work on Steam. However, I did make a game controller for Steam. Unless you are you using an Xbox controller or are you using a PS5 controller? Could be a trophy even. Okay. You have both. To me, the PS5 controller works a lot better because you don't get that weird drifting issue when you're using a game controller with this game. And I noticed there's a weird drifting issue. And all the Xbox controllers I had the exact same thing. Over and over again. But the PlayStation 4, 5 controller does work on Steam. The only thing that you cannot do, unfortunately, is set the hook. I'm gonna. See, I got our fish on. I'm using a standalone. Now, before I had my main account on Steam at level 40. The reason why I stopped playing that account. And people don't understand why I stopped playing a level 40 account. Because before, they did a firmware update on the game controllers, and it kind of screwed up the PS5 controller for me. And I didn't like using the Xbox controller because I'm not going to do it right now because I'll probably lose a fist if I try to show you what happens. But picture that you're looking, you're moving your, you know, your character, you know, trying to turn around. Sometime it gets stuck and your character spins around and around and around. And I don't know why. It's not a drifting issue because there's no drifting issue on that controller whatsoever. But it's something to do with the game itself. I think it's a sturgeon. I'm starting to think that's what this is. But like I said, they did a firmware update with Sony and their PlayStation 5 controllers. So the haptic feedback and the, and what else is that thing called? Something to do with the motion controls with the controller. And since then, when you go on Steam, you'll notice that the light on the bars and stuff change color. And you can no longer use the that program that I bought specifically for this game. Hey there, I can't understand Russian, I do apologize. I gotta turn around pretty quick too, because he's gonna spurn me if I don't. If you notice, when you're turning a boat, the speed drops down to one speed. So basically, that's why you burn your reel. But when you're going forward, you see your speed changes to 3. So you're going to a steady speed with trolling. But while you're turning, it drops down to 1. So that's why the fish gets a better head start and why you start burning your reel when you're turning. Because it don't turn fast enough. That's why I'm always make sure the fish is facing forward and I can follow it, not behind me. This is hands down a sturgeon. Unless it's a really, really big Atlantic, but I don't know. Definitely going to be a challenge trying to land this. Every so often you hear that cracking sound. It's a very heavy fish. Yeah, show you a map. Right here. H3. God, it just won't slow down. He's gonna burn me while even driving. And he pretty got a good start on me when he got hooked, because he was already half spooled my line when I was. What was I doing, anyways? Oh, yeah, I was looking at my fish. Hopefully, the fish that's on the other reel is not too big. Otherwise, it's going to spool me, but I'd rather catch these fish first. Such a good nice bend to the rod. The line doesn't even fit properly on the eyes anymore. He's right directly underneath me. This is the side rod, right? Yeah, so I might try stopping the boat. Kind of afraid of stopping it, but I can always start it back up if it goes again. It's not done yet. Okay. That was risky. I'm not doing that again. I grabbed the wrong rod. I could have lost this fish. Yeah, give me a moment, okay? Oh no, I gotta turn the fish around. I'm gonna hit the buoys. Not good, not good, not good at all. God dang it. Please turn around. Do something. You know, technically, if we can't go out there, the fish should not be allowed to go out there. I don't. It's game over with this fish. I can't catch it with this. Unless I can get this fish to turn around. That's not fair. I'm gonna try to catch it. The fish knows it can get away now. That's not right. I'm against the buoys, that's why. I cannot turn this fish around. I'm not reeling anymore. I'm gonna have to try to see if it tires out. I gotta hope it gets off. I can't fight it no more. God dang it. Sorry, guys. That's what happened, we get stuck against the buoys. You cannot fight the fish anymore. It's kind of disadvantage, really, because you can't go where the fish can go. If you can't go, then the fish shouldn't go either. That's the way it should go, but... I guess the devs made it that way, that if the fish get beyond that area, then their fist gets away. Same on Volkov. Not Volk. Well, Volkov has the exact same problem, and so does Tongue. Tongue has that issue too. So if you're still there, I'm going back here at H3. Okay, as for that program, I will find it real fast. Alright, there you go. Yeah, because he said he wanted to use the, wanted me to show him where I'm going fishing on the map. Oh, you're welcome. Now, I did look. There's no copyright at all whatsoever on the website. So, I did link the program there. If they had a copyright protection on the site, I wouldn't be sharing that. That is definitely a sturgeon. What am I doing? That's another thing to be careful. The buds are very touchy. I laid the controller down my lap and that back button kind of pushed right here. The PlayStation 5 controller is very touchy, I tell you. Nice, I mean. Wonder how long that fight was. 30 minutes. That fight was air in between 25 and 30 minutes. I was robbed from that fish. I had no problem catching it. Maybe they got a better RNG now. No. Okay, here we go again. Why is this rod again? I don't think it can be rod. This reel can handle another long play. On its standalone. I do got a steam version. Well, the big fish is definitely active. If I can get the fish to stay that way, I can actually able to have more room with this. Another heavy fish, can you hear that cracking sound? It's funny how the fish never got off. I let the line go completely slack and it still didn't go off. This one ain't as big as the last one. I don't feel like that. I mean, it's big, but it's not as strong as the last one. This one is. I'm keeping up with this one. This one is just underneath the boat. trying to turn around. I don't know, I might need to stop the boat, otherwise I'm trying to figure out if I need to stop the boat or what. It seems like it's still running pretty hard too. As long as I can keep it in this line, I have enough water to run it. Because he's going right straight that way now. He's going right straight to the buoys again. Yep, he's going right that way. Because over this way is a dead end. I can't go this way. Following the exact same direction as the last one. Lucky it's only 84 or 86 silver to repair this friction brake. I think it's another sturgeon now. I thought maybe it might be Atlantic, but I don't know, unless it's a near trophy. I gotta see something here. I don't like keep looking at that map, but I have to. I gotta figure which way this fish is going. Kinda get an idea of how much space I have between and the buoys, and it's heading toward that way. You can see the line back there where it's going, you can see where the buoys are at. As long as it keeps turning, then I might have a chance. I think it's getting tired. Still doing that head shake and still just trying to run. I'm gonna stop the boat. I might be able to pull it in. Action away is turning around, so I might be able to follow it. If I can get to turn that way, then I got plenty of space. Just not tired enough, I can't slow it down. Is just getting closer and closer to the buoys. And I can't control which way it's gonna go. RNH2. Once I reach line one, then I'm gonna be run out of space. Strong fish, Jesus. Guys, turning around towards where I want it to go. Go for no flips. I'm watching chat. Someone made a competition in chat here. It says, GoFund no clips. Actually, I say no clips made. GoFund no clips. He's turning around. Well, I've been fighting this fish since morning. I think pretty great that this is a trophy Atlantic. Or it could be just a fat sturgeon. These fish are burning the hell on my reel. Like I said, lucky it's not too expensive fixing. I'm just trying to keep my strength up. Once I start seeing it start to drop, that's why I keep drinking. They turned completely around. But it's okay though. I don't mind it turning around. I'm starting to realize that I gotta sacrifice a little bit of damage to reel so I can get the fish to turn around. Although I'd rather have it turn towards the town than out towards the opposite direction. Yeah, that fish completely did a U-turn. I'm gonna spend my whole stream trying to catch this fish. I don't know how long I've been dragging the last fish for. I'm gonna try stopping the boat. See if I can get control of this fish. Not done yet. I don't know, I can't tell. It looks like it's coming up. Then look here, it takes off too. He ain't done yet. I think it's done. It's just swimming down. Dang, it's just not done yet. They're both running. I got two runners on. I hear the airline just whipping back there. You think when the fish is tired, then it tricks you. Please be done. Sturgeon, like I thought. That's all it was, a 20 kg sturgeon. Jesus, he took that much of a bite. Oh, it's a Ladoga. The hell is this damn thing? How did I get back where I left off? That's funny. That fish went back where I caught it. 139 T's left, plenty of tea. Well, it's real to get abused. Oh, that Fitbit's got smacked hard. At least in my mind that I still make a profit because that reel only going to take only 86 silver, 84, 86 silver to fix. So despite it getting abused like that, it's fine. Missed like the whole entire hour catching that damn fish. Catching both of the fish, actually. Both fish we took 30 minutes. So some serious time wasted. Oh no, here we go again. Oh, it's a mill rod. Okay, I thought it was that rod. Something. hate my perch. hold on one sec. Doing pretty good. I spent a whole hour catching two fish. One got away. I'm starting to think it was this fish right here because I hooked another fish like this and fought for a whole 30 minutes. I lost it because it got into the buoys, and after that I could not keep control of the first fish. Came back here on this hole right here, H3. Then I hooked into that Ladoga sturgeon, and then that one took a half hour to catch, and it was only 20 kg, so I didn't think Ladoga sturgeon was that strong, because that damn thing did some damage to that reel. I got a fish on, I can hear the line. I didn't get to reply to you because I was busy fighting with them fish for a whole hour. I'll show you what I'm using. Ooh, that's a nice pike. I'm using the Heaven Creek Clumsy 10005. I'm using 2-aught hooks, the raised treble. The raised treble is not that expensive. I think it's like, what, 15 silver? Maybe 20? Not really that much. I'm gonna drift right off the area. I do got a better, decent rod now for bottom fishing. Common carps? You think there's a chance for trophies there? I always want to get a common carp trophy out of Old Bird, just so I get that trophy card. But I do have this right here. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's capable of handling those fish. 25 kg low capacity with the Beluga Narga. 14.5. It's a little stronger than the HSV, in my opinion. Okay, seeing it's slow, I could check some stuff. Bird. Still need the... Wait, I got the Gibble, I got the Crucian. Common. So I technically just need to find a few of these other fish for the trophies. I still want to get the mosquito trophies. I've been after this perch for so long. I know where it's at, but the biggest perch I caught was a trophy on another water body. I think that was on Volkov. I'm actually gonna stop the boat. Because I'm not gonna catch anything during the night. Let that sink to the bottom. Okay, so you said the cocoa cream. So the exact same common bait that's used on bear. I think I have that bait actually. Cocoa and cream, 16 pop up, and I do have the cocoa nectar. I'm supposed there's going to be the corn too. I think there's a cream corn, ain't there? Actually, I'm using the wrong lure. Don't think I want to use that one, though. Not really saying that I'm gonna catch any fish at this spot, but usually these little tiny these holes that are shallow holes are you can find chars. I caught a red char, but that was like a bycatch, I think. Okay, it's touching bottom. Okay, you said 3558. I might check that spot after. What sector is that? Or I can just look it up. Not even getting jig step at all. Actually, I might just go to Oprah, like you said, suggest it. Because the reason why for that, the weather is about to be bad. And I think it's going to be, this thing, this is the win. It is going to, actually, it's 1.7. So I think it's fine then. A nice rippus. I mean, the biggest perp that I caught from Oldberg was a 14.5 kg. This was on Samolina. And I'll show you exactly where I hooked that fish. I hooked it right here. I don't want Netflix, go away. Around 4720, I was casting towards this area right here. I caught it by that log that you see and by the bridge. I wasn't even after no carps. I was just after the crucians and the gibbles at that time. I just made it to Oldberg. I just unlocked it on that time when I caught that carp. I caught it off my starter kit rod. Right here, the Lasardi 2, I caught it off of that reel. Off the Asteria. I'm gonna do one more cast, then we're gonna get out on this rolling. Oh, great char. I'm just gonna keep going until the ticket expires. Now I tell you, when I reached the arch, I started losing more fish than anything. I guess while we're waiting for a fish, I'm gonna set this up. I'm gonna guess we're gonna be using the classic pop-up. Eight core 8. I might have to go buy some corn here after. I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to. Oh, way out of the way. Oh, okay. I guess we'll take a visit to Volkov real quick. And I'm gonna go repair that rail. And then while we're repairing it, we'll go to Oldburg and go see if we can get some carps. I need to figure out where that 3558 is at. Okay, so it's definitely going to be in this area right here. I'm just gonna pull it up in. Clip 8. Yeah. I tried. Never any fish patrol for cafe or here. Hours, let's see what we've got. 715 silver. Ain't too bad, at least over 8,000. Okay, we're gonna go to Volkoff, like I said. I might be able to get a couple things. I had real took a beating. I think it's this one right here. No? Nope. How was it the middle one that got beaten? And that's this one. I'm not going to plan to fix the line guide until it's over 50%. I'm not too worried about the line guides. God, why is that so loud? $88 silver. Not too bad. I'm pretty sure something in the with the corn here. Is it flavored white? Cream flavor white. I think that's what I want right there. I think I need to buy more of these. I'm not sure. Something I'm kind of low on. I don't know what it is, but no, well, it's something here. I think it's the bait. I'll buy one set of that. That's fine. I'd rather be at 99. Okay, ground bait. I don't know if I can make anything because my ground bait level is not that high. I know I can use ground, can't use cornflour even. I think I can use the ground crackers. Or ground peas? Hold on, maybe I can use brown peas. You need brown peas, I just buy a bunch of them here. I don't even know what I'm looking for here. Cocoa and cream. I think that's what I'm looking for. Now, I can't even use that even. Level 60. What are these? Back to the can use cream, that's good. I think it's cream I want to use. I wish I could buy something here. I can't. Don't have anything to use. I can't even use cream bead either. That's 60% as well. Think something down that I might be able to use. Nope, this is what is that? Also 60%. Anything to do with sweet cream or any type of cream I can't use. I'm gonna hope that is gonna work because I don't know what else will. Hey Matrix, how you doing? No problem, dude. You gotta look for another hour. I put question marks. I don't know what if this will work or not. Ground peas. Wait, I can't use that? Gosh. And I can't return the damn freaking bait either. So that's kind of useless. So I guess we're going to do without brown bait. I didn't look how much this sturgeon was worth. This should be a spot right here. Flip 8. Your PC case is kind of cool. This is the frog spotting. That's the eel spot, yeah. I think the frog spot was actually down there by the bridge. Now I'm thinking about it. And ground bait's at 43%. I need 60% to unlock the cocoa and cream. You caught your first big trophy? I got my trophy eel over here when I was trying to catch, go out that blue tag perch where no clips caught. And it's not your fault for being late. Usually I don't do streams on Saturdays and Sundays, but seeing I miss Wednesday, that's why I decided to do a stream today here. Today. Wasted a whole hour catching one sturgeon. I lost one sturgeon after fighting for 30 minutes. I lost it when it went beyond the damn buoys on Arch. Then it's the second one. took 30 minutes as well. That one was only a 20 kg, and it was a Ladoga. I hope that's a carp on that one. Is there a bite on that one? Either the hooks are too big or just, oh. That's a subtle bite, so it's either a crucian or a gibble. The leader is broken. Wait. It broke a 20 kg leader. That's not locked. How is that even possible to break a leader? I'm confused. That should not broke. I'm confused as freaking hell. Stupid damn leg. Did I have the right leader on, or did I have the wrong leader on? I swore I put 20 kg leaders on. My snake? What's going on? Oh, shut up. I was like, wondering why I'm not getting no fish on it. I didn't even cast it. Now, all he's got 20 kg leaders on. I don't even know. This spot's supposed to be good for carp, but I only caught one fish here. Well, two actually. I don't even know what I'm fishing for. I know the frogs are biting right now. I
Actually, guys, I think I'm gonna call it quits. I think I've been going for 3 hours. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys did, be sure to hit that like button. I appreciate it. And thank you all for watching. And yeah, I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys.